Hey, what's up guys? Hope you're doing well. Since the firmware 2.0 came out for this camera, it seems like everybody is interested in the Panasonic G9, which is really great. And it really helps that the price just plummeted down to like around $900. I got myself a second one. Well, I got one for my wife for $850, brand new from B&H Photo. That's just incredibly hard to believe that you can get this powerful of a camera with this crazy video specs for that price. It's just unbelievable right now. But I thought this would be a good time to share an updated version of my camera color settings for video and what I use in post to bring it back to a more neutral starting place. So first off, if you can't tell by the title, I use Cinelite D rather than V-Log. I find for me personally, that's what I like to use all the time. I don't want to be changing from Cinelite D to V-Log to natural because I want to keep my color grading consistent. And I feel like Cinelite D is the best all around profile. V-Log is great if you only shoot 30 or 24 frames per second and you use 10-bit. It's a great profile, but it really falls apart if you start to use 8-bit or 4K 60. It just turns blocky and kind of messed up. The problem with using Cinelite D is that it really kind of messes up the colors. It really kind of messes up the saturation, the hue, the intensity, the lightness and darkness of different colors. And you end up getting this image that is fixable in post, but it's hard to do it yourself. So to make life easier, I created a lookup table to easily just kind of fix what I like fixing and make it more color accurate and speed up my color grading in post. To do this, I just used a color chart and created LUTs in different lighting conditions that would help me later on in post. I'm not gonna get all technical about how this is done. I'm not gonna show you how this is done. I'm just gonna give you the files and my settings and you guys do what you want with it. If you like it, use it. If you don't, don't. I'm not saying this is perfect. I'm not saying that this is the best LUT out there. It might not be. This is just what I use and this is my settings that I prefer. And if you like it, just go down in the comments below and download the files and they're yours. I'm not charging anything for it. I'm not asking you to sign up or donate or even subscribe for it. Just do what you want. So this is really important, but the settings that I use is my color settings are obviously set to Cinelite D. I have contrast set to -5. I have sharpness set to -5. Noise reduction is set to 0. And saturation is set to -1. It's important that you don't mess with the highlight shadow settings anymore. Bring that back to default, that 0, 0. And the last thing that I change is I go into eye dynamic and I set that to high. And the reason I do this is because I feel like it does squeeze a little bit more dynamic range. It's not as much as V-Log, but it's pretty close, like to the point where I find myself never wanting to use V-Log for extra dynamic range because this gets it really close and it's easily gradable with 8-bit footage. Next, all you have to do, obviously, is slap your video footage right into your video editor, use this LUT, and it should bring this back to a more neutral tone. After that, you can do whatever you want. You can adjust the sliders, you can adjust the color, you can add more creative looks on top of that. You can grade it however you want. This is just meant to kind of bring Cinelite D into a more normal looking color profile that doesn't have these kind of weird skin tones, that doesn't have these kind of weird color tones and color casts and shadow weirdness. But that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know if there's anything else you want to see, and I will talk to you guys later. Peace.